月日は経っていた。その色に詰めて泣いている。あ、時を重ねた許したて僕らは。少し苦くて誰かに合わせた味を無駄に試す朝なんで、愛想笑いいつからかなくなってる。こんな私を見たらどう思う。
Testing. Okay. Am I alive? Okay, I'm alive. Hello everyone. Welcome to another stream. This time is between Aaron 65 and Master. And yes, Aaron changed name into Ari Maki. So, Rakan, can you use the title a bit? Hello everyone. You haven't missed anything because it just been started. This is still the warm-up section. A bit crazy map to be honest though for a warm-up. A lot of sliders and okay then. Well, a good performance though from Ari. Okay then, never mind. I talk too soon. So yeah, I am still Vincent, your regular commentator here. Rakan is also streaming, so hello Rakan. Alright, that is the first warm up. We are now going to the second one. Also, hello Prisma in the chat. Well, I cannot see the chat in the also client, but it should be fine. Well, it's still a warm up, so nevertheless, it's still okay. It's still fine. Okay, never mind, I can see it. So in the because your match are being streamed, sometimes you have to change the position because we need to know which one is in the upper bracket and one is in the lower one. Usually team red is the upper bracket team and team blue is the lower bracket. Okay, I think they are still changing position now. It should be fine. Okay. Hey, yep, still changing. Please mind the background noise in my own, you know. This song is a bit childish though, to be honest, but you know, good map. Alright, I think the next one is with TT. Yeah. Another bit. One moment. I think banjo do banjo things. Okay, let's hold up a bit. Okay, yep, it's been reset. Okay, yeah, so like 1 hour before this, the banjo and also server had a, you know, had a technical issue. So yeah, it should be fine right now. We are going to the second warm-up. What the? Okay. This is the okay. What is this map? What if? Is it speed? Well, all I can say is it's very bursty and mustard already. This is really not a warm-up friendly map, especially if you DT on, but you know, a quite interesting pick though, to be honest. Oh my god. Oh, okay. Oh, it's very wild. It's very wild. How long is this map? 4 minutes of this insanity? Oh my god, this map is just... Oh, okay. Oh yeah, by the way, hello Cherry. Okay, so this fine. Yes, this is 101, how not to warm up. More like how to flex or... destroy your finger, to be honest though.
Bust map or a warm up.
This is not a. No, this is a DT.
Oh, it's
how?
DT. Oh.
How?
Wait, what star is this? 5.5 with DT? This is like 7 stars, right?
No. This is almost here. This is closer to 8 star though.
Okay.
What the? Okay, so 101 how to destroy your finger before the warm up. So do not do this, but it's the player choice. So
you can do this though, if you are Masdor. Masdor is like holding two times more accuracy than Arimaki.
Yes, and the combo also, but like, bro, why would you destroy your finger in the warm up? I this doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, I guess it's a strategy from the player to just destroy his opponent's fingers.
Okay, hold on, Ari is be right back.
BRB.
I'm going to the bathroom. I mean,
he's gonna cool down his fingers.
I think he will soak it in cold water, though, to be honest.
So, what are these player seats, by the way?
Arimaki has the upper bracket seat, I think, while Master has the lower one. I might be wrong because I can't see the seat. But
they changed the name, by the way.
Yep, they changed the name. It's not. It's supposed
not Aaron
to be
anymore.
Aaron. Yeah. It changed to Ari. Well, pronunciation wise, yes, it is way easier. By the way, a bit introduction to our player, Parimaki from Brazil. He is really good at DT, no mod, and also hidden. While Matstor is a pass player, a DT pass player. So yes, although the top plays really much of DTFC, he also already passed some of the 7-star, even 8-star map, surprisingly. For example, Painter of the Tempest, Awakening by Sunless Rise, and Everything Will Freeze, the frozen one. Damn. Well, Ill White, Ari has
high star rating player.
Yep, Mazdor is a high star rating player, while Ari is more on the DTN SG consistency. Okay then. Well, yeah, I don't have any big expectation, to be honest though, with this map, because it's very high star. You know, I think the title suits very well, because this map title is Mr. Kill Myself. So yeah. Okay, I think that is the end for warm up. A bit
very impressive,
you know,
draft, by the way, by Arimaki.
I mean, yeah, he left me just going to the bathroom. Okay, let me go Australian mode. Hold on a second. Oh. Okay. Yep. Okay. All right, let's see. Arimaki with 26, Mazdor with 63. That's mean Mazdor is going either pick first or then first. So let's see what's the outcome will be.
Gotta be pick first.
By the way, there is literally advantages and disadvantages between picking first or banning first. If you pick first, that means you are going to secure what's your next goal will be. Okay, Mazdor is going to pick and he's immediately picked DT. Huh? Okay, so that is not how that works. When you want to pick first, then just say it, pick first.
Yeah, he messed up second. His order.
Yeah, I know. I mean, yeah, it's fine. I think, you know, I think Mazdor is still new to the tournament stuff, so it's fine. We will adapt though, hopefully. So yeah, when the referee is asking you want to pick or ban first, just say it. Oh yeah, I want to pick first, or I want to ban first. Not like immediately say, I want to ban DT. Is it?
Yeah, but you know, everybody might be banning DT one though.
Who knows? Because from both perspective, from either Mazdor and Ari, both of them really like DT, so if they both ban DT, aka no DT map in this match, then yeah.
Yeah, we'll see though. We'll see.
Yes, so we'll see about it. Yes, sir. By the way, Jerry, how are you doing now? A bit exhausted.
I just finished a tournament.
Like, oh, others.
Yeah, I got swept to 0-3.
Okay, never mind. Good luck next time, bro. You can ask me for training, to be honest though, but
I have another one though, in 50 minutes from now.
Oh, so that's why you're training here, just for a bit though. It's fine. Okay then. So Mazdor want to ban first. So yeah, let's see what will he ban. Hold on, let me pull out the sheet also. Aaron and Mazdor, sheet number 53. Just in case the client a bit broken again. Let's
and
see.
Mazdor ban HR1.
Mazdor ban HR1. Okay. HR1 is banned.
It's a consistency map, right?
Ban DT2, okay. HR1 and DT2, yep. Because we are banning HR consistency and DT finger control.
Maybe Eric Mackey is a little bit afraid of Mazdor's DT skills, perhaps?
I think so, but to be honest though, Master is really a high star rating pass player, so who knows. By the way,
and we are going low AR.
Already? It's you too, alright. Okay, I also got another information from the other two match. Basically, for Fate, iCat won and Outers won by default because their enemy did not show up, so RIP. We got 4 for Fate already. Okay, I have nothing to say about it, to be honest though. But like,
so, yeah. So is this our last match for today?
I think so. Hold on, there is still 2 more, I think, at 18 UTC. And 18:30, I think it's Pecora's match. Yeah, we'll be streamed though. So yeah, let's see. First map of the day, already on the raiding aspect with HD2. Okay. Both players are... Okay, hold on, Benjo. Benjo, come on. Benjo. Benjo. Okay then, yep, there you go. We're back. Okay. Ariumaki still holding the SS while Mudstall already dropping a couple hundred... Okay, never mind. Ari just lost the SS. Okay, well, Ari still has the upper advantage for the combo. Okay, Mudstall just... Okay, I think Mudstall cannot read AR8, but... You know, who knows, maybe just a bit still stiff on the hand because not enough warm up. Because
maybe,
yeah, this is
overwarm his fingers from that DT map.
I mean, yeah, to be honest though.
He lost all his long AR finger control.
Yes, I think, or he's not. Okay, I think he's. Oh, hold on a second. If you look at the unstable rate bar, I think Master just overstreaming that part. Yep, I think it's too far. It's too slow for Master.
He's hitting everything way too early.
Yep, I think it's either he cannot read or he is too fast on the reaction time.
Yeah, well, he's comfortable on this AR.
Yep, well, it's a consequence to be honest though. They play AR 9.5, I think. Hold on a second. That map, if you put DT on it, wasn't it like, hold on, AR 9 plus DT is... Okay, so that is very high AR, so that is almost like AR 10.5. Free, I guess. So yeah, makes sense why Ari is picking this map, because it is AR8 and the transition between reading AR8 and AR10 above is really hard, unless you are one of the top players who can really read DTSR.
Yeah, but okay, we'll see though, because there's only one AR8 map in the whole pool, which is this.
And the rest is just like, yep.
Maybe Mesador might be able to pull some points back.
Yep. Well, Ari just break at the FD. Yep, Ari just break at the long burst there. Kinda unfortunate. Well, but yeah, it's fine already. Master is kinda unlucky at this pick, so Arimaki going to take the score this one. First point goes to Ari. Yep. Ari almost FC though. He got slide the brick at the burst part in the end. Well,
yeah, Mastodon not really researching his opponents well enough.
I think so. Alright, it's Master pick now. I think Master going to pick GT1 or something that's much more in his, you know,
his skill range.
Have his skill range, so probably HD1. Or Nomad 1 and Nomad 2. I think that is the Mudstall's range, judging from his high SR.
Yeah, he might. Oh, he's going with DT1.
Oh, yeah. Okay, my prediction was correct. Like, augers.
Just like when he was rolling his rolls.
Yep, okay, sticking out with DT1 with his pick. We are going to DT consistency. How do you even read? Okay, then rock on! We have another scuffing coming! I cannot see the overlay.
We are back? Nope, we're not.
Nope, still not. Well, it's fine. Okay, nice, we're back. Okay then, never mind. Please forget the scuffness. Alright.
It's okay. It's Orange turning stuff turning anyways.
Yep. Alright. Both players starting strong here. Okay, Master with the first 100 there. It's fine though. He can still back up in this.
And they're both hitting the early section of this map well, pretty well with both accuracy.
Pretty well. Well, it's still okay. Both players are not SSing this one. Okay, never mind. Master's having a bit of trouble hitting those sliders perfectly.
They're still holding their combo, so it's fine.
Yep, okay, Ariamaki just dropped the accuracy on that slider part. Yes, if you cannot really do alternating on those, I recommend you single that. It's only 210 PBM. Okay, Ariamaki just break at this slider part. Okay then, well, that will be a advantage for Master.
Yeah, the score is gonna increase in size gap. And it's close to 100k soon.
Almost close to 400 right now, halfway through the map.
But Ariamaki still has a chance though, if Master breaks within like the next 10 seconds.
Yes, maybe.
Yeah, chances are pretty low for him to come back.
Well, this is Master pick though, so I think Master going to get an
point
for this. Yep. Okay, hello, not... Okay, then Ariamaki just chokes. That means this is a 3 point for Master. By the way, from the Twitch chat, we got Not Pound. Hello, Not Pound. Also Lurian Surfy and Cross. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the stream. Yes, this is the second map. Alright, let's see if Master's going to FC this. A bit of map left. Well, I think Master's going
the
to FC.
Pretty easy.
Yep, okay. Last part. Okay, I remember just break in the end. Okay, congratulations, Master. You just FC BT1 and gain a point. Perfect combo also. Poggers.
Both players trading points right now.
Yep.
Winning both of their picks.
101. Winning both their pick. We are now waiting for Ari's pick.
And he's going with precision.
Immediately going to Hard Rock 2. We are going to test. Ari is literally going to test Master reading ability, precision ability to be honest, in Hard Rock 2. Besides, it is a 10, it's CS 6.5. And to be honest though, this is the first HR pick that's been streamed. Because last time, you know what happened, the HR gone, it's not picked, and then it's only 4-2 or 4-0, 1, yep. Well, congratulations, the first HR2 that will be streamed is between Ariamaki and Master. Alright then, let's see it. Okay, Benjo, okay. Here we go. Master starting off a bit rough with the less accuracy.
But he seems comfortable.
It's still early though. Yep, he seems comfortable. Well, I mean, he just read air 10 plus in the warm up, so.
Oh, he dropped him on the triple.
Yep. Hold on, I need to zoom in for this match. Hold on, let me zoom in real quick.
Right. It's actually not that small though. CS 6.5.
Yes, if you're on full screen.
Yeah, right.
Oh, Ari drops, just break at the...
Followed by Master.
Ari just... Okay, both of them miss at the... Okay, never mind. Master drop again. The boss is here in the
spot though.
Yep. And also the accuracy advantage. The thing about in this map though is that the boss ladder part, you must follow it to the end. You cannot just, you know, pray for it in the middle to cheese it. You really cannot cheese the boss ladder pattern in this map with HR.
It's like really small circles.
Yep, it's really small. And also the slider one, you remember the slider overlay? It's also quite small.
Yeah.
Okay, a third the map now.
But well, if this goes on, I'm pretty sure it's gonna be every Makis to win.
Yep, I think so. Yep, I can clearly see it is going to be Ori Makis W for this pick.
Ezlo has a pretty high combo, but Aramaki has just been holding his for way longer than him.
Yep, and also the accuracy is pretty. I think that's a wrap then. Yep, no chance for Master to recover from that. Okay, then Aramaki is pretty bad. It doesn't matter now. Yep,
yeah.
Aramaki takes the point for this one. Hold on, didn't you say you have a match right now?
No, it's in 30 minutes from now. I have time for this.
Okay, so at 18 UTC? Yep.
Yeah.
Okay then. Alright. Now it is Master pick. Let's see what's...
See if they'll trade wins again.
Yep. I mean, the one speaking, usually the losing one. I don't think so, you know, sometimes it happens and sometimes,
Yeah, Mazdor had only one miss though, so like, it could have been... It could have gone either way actually. Matt.
Yes, sir. Well, both of them did a bit poorly, to be honest though, at the bus slider section.
Yeah.
But yeah, that is Hard Rock 2 for you. A bit not used to. Okay, Master is picking Nomad 4. We are going to tech battle with the technology maps.
So far, every match, there's always Nomad 4, by the way. Everyone's been picking it.
It's been Nomad 4 been taken, Nomad 2, Nomad 1, Nomad 3, and Hidden 1. Also DT2 sometimes. Hard Rocks is hardly been picked, to be honest though. If I correctly see the sheet, Hard Rock is, yep, rarely been picked. The most picked one is Hidden 1, I Know Why, and Nomads. Alright, we are tuning in for Nomad 4. Okay, both players, a bit rough start for both of them, already dropping some accuracy. Okay, Master is dropping even more accuracy. The accuracy advantage is now going to Ori.
So is the score?
Yep, sir. He got higher accuracy and Nomad in score fit too. Now he got better scores.
Yeah, by far though. It's like, it's growing to 30k soon. Oh, and he drops his combo.
Okay, Ori just broke at
this slider. That is actually very, very, very bad. Because this map is actually really short, so...
Yes, and Master is still holding the combo though, but... Yeah, I'm still a bit worried. Okay, Ori just broke again at this slider part. Master still holding the combo, even though his accuracy is a bit over... Okay, then Ori just broke again. Master, if you can increase your accuracy, that will be a good opportunity because you already have a such huge combo but small accuracy, while Ori, unfortunately, although have higher accuracy, the combo is detect. Yeah. The thing about Nomad 4 is that it's really easy to slide the break since it's a tech map.
Yeah.
But, well, let's see.
But
we
Master
might
is
have a...
Combo still, so...
Yep.
There's no way Arimaki is gonna come back from this.
Okay, then never mind. Master just dropped. Yes, I think there is no much time though.
Yeah.
Okay, Master just have to hold in a bit. And it should be a wrap. I think Master is going to take the W for this one. Okay, Ori just and Master break at the last burst. Master take the point here. Although it
we
is,
we might be seeing a tiebreaker, by the way. If they keep on trading their points like this,
they keep on trading their points. Yes, it's true. They are even now 2-2. Now let's see what Ori is gonna pick for the fifth one. Number 2. Okay, we are going to burst and stream with Number 2.
Azor is actually pretty good at that as well, though. From
if you are looking
on. Warm-up DT. It's literally all streams and bursts.
Yes, but that is very high star rating though, and the BPM also questionable.
Yep. Higher AR and higher BPM, way higher than this map.
Okay.
And into Nomad 2 we go.
Alright. Into Nomad 2, Bencho, come on. Okay, Bencho, hold on. Okay, we are now going to Nomad 2. Master already dropping some accuracy there at start.
And then Ari is holding SS.
Yep. Hold on, Master is over streaming. Ari just dropped his combo on the slider part.
But it's only the first 100, so maybe it should be fine. If he keeps his accuracy.
Yep, Master in the other hand is kept over streaming, I think. Okay, then never mind, he got it correctly this time. Alright, we are now going to almost the hard section right now. Okay, the score is going to Master. Oh, still on Ari. Oh, still on Master. Okay, back to Master. Okay, then never mind. Master just break. Yep, because in this map, there is one point where the burst is actually not a burst. The triple is not a burst, just a tapping. Okay, hold on.
Oh, it's a slower BPM.
It's just a slower BPM. Yep, you just gotta tap it. Okay, Bencho. Okay, we are back now. Bencho do Bencho things. Okay. Well, if this keep on going on, I think R is gonna take the W. Okay, Master just break again on the boss slider part.
But the next pick will be Mastoff though, so we might
see another tiebreaker, but who knows? Because both players are trading points with their pick. Alright, almost at the end. I think Master doesn't have any more chances, right? Unless both of them just break. Even though both Ari just chokes a lot there on the bus slider part, literally. You know what? If I look correctly at Master's cursor, I don't think Master has the ability to do flow aim, to be honest though, because if you look closely where the part he break, his cursor is a bit delayed and it's a bit quite snappy. Not like under aiming, you know when you sometimes move your cursor and then you're not comfortable with flow aim, so then you must keep it like in a ziggy zaggy. I think that's what happened to Master there at the first section.
Actually don't know that because I am a stream player actually.
Well, if you're a stream player, I suppose you know how to flow stream works. Yep. And also space stream.
I actually have an FC though on the songs compilation.
Oh, okay.
The most recent one.
Okay. Masters for Nomad 1. Going back to Nomad 1, we are going to aim consistency with a bit of bursty.
Did Masno win DT1? Or was it
Aaron? Hold on, DT1 winner is Master, yes. So this is literally both of them are... Yes, because both players are winning their own pick.
Yep.
If Master won this one, we are going to tiebreaker. Alright, both players are ready. We are going to Nomad 1.
Tiebreaker hype?
Maybe. You'll see it.
Okay, hitting the start triples. Very good sign.
Yep.
Dropping accuracy by Macedon though.
Yep, it's a bit... But it's still too early though. So yeah, we might see some comeback from Macedon.
Yeah, as long as he holds his accuracy. Both players actually.
Yes. The thing about Nomad 1, and everyone already knows it, either you FC, you choke, or you shit miss a lot.
Yeah.
So yeah, let's just see.
But Maslow has his pick buff, so he should be fine.
Yes. I hope Master... So this will be either Master FCing with a bit low egg, maybe 92-94, or Arimaki not FCing but choke.
Yes.
Yeah.
This is accuracy though. Is that like 100?
I think it's like 3-100 though, because this just made a combo though. Yep.
Oh, and he dropped another 100.
Yep. Ari with the... Okay, Ari just broke. I think Master's going to one by combo game if he can keep his combo.
Yeah, the score is gonna go all the way to Master's side.
Yep, if Master did not broke.
which seems like he's really comfortable though, so we should be fine.
Yes, I think Master's strategy here is just to keep the combo going, so then he will win by combo gaming.
Yeah, it is his slow session right now. So yep, just free combo for him.
Free combo for him.
The triples, nice.
Yep, although it's
a bit
over though. Yep.
And the doubles as well. These doubles are actually kind of annoying to hit, because like they're delayed doubles, not like really really fast doubles.
So yep, you can
need a little bit of finger that control.
Yep, let's just say that those doubles, yep, nice. Let's just say that those doubles are literally you just either want to single tap those or you can alternate it a bit. But yeah. Okay, accuracy wise, Master doesn't looking Master's not really
the
good.
The score is actually really close, thanks to Arimaki's accuracy.
Arimaki's accuracy is still the sub. Okay, come on. Benjo, I think I need to bonk Benjo. Be right back, hold on.
Oh, we're back. Okay, you can keep your bet for now.
Yep. Okay, the score is slowly going to Master's area. It's looking good with the combo advantage.
Yeah, the combo gap gaming is way too wide. 400
well, are you
combo
lucky?
Advantage for Master. Yep, 400 combo advantage.
Okay, I'm now going to watch Arumaki here. Looks like he is really comfortable with the aiming part with such high accuracy. While Master, on the other hand, is trying hard to keep the combo for the combo gaming advantage.
Oh,
okay,
are we
just
combo
break? Oh
okay, there
no!
There goes his comeback.
Yep, I think that's rapid. Unless Master's break at the ending part, because you know, at the ending we have a triangle and also a star aiming part, which a little bit disorientating for some players if they cannot read it completely.
Yeah, but there's not enough time. The gap.
Yes,
is like
and the sorry, 160. Yep. Well, I think we are going to another tiebreaker.
Vincent!
Yep, this will be a tiebreaker.
The first tiebreaker, right?
Yes. I think this will be the first tiebreaker, although the previous one already played the tiebreaker just for fun, to be honest though. But yeah, it should be fine.
Oh wait, actually there was another tiebreaker.
No, they just played for fun, to be honest. It's not a big try. Okay then, yep, that is a wrap then. Master's winning by combo gaming while Arimaki just keep, you know, shit missing. Okay then. Yes, that goes it. We are now 3-on-3. Master winning with Nomad 1 by combo gaming while Ari shit missed too much. We are now going to tiebreaker, the crystallized by Camellia. And also, this map is almost like Nomad 1, you know, but much more bursty and a bit part of technology. So I think if Master and combo game again Arimaki in the tiebreaker, he will have a big advantage for this one.
Yeah, it's not tech if it's not Camellia.
Yep, it's not tech if it's not Camellia, and it is not a big burst and also streaming part if it's not Camellia. Well, we all know what Camellia types, so alright, let's see.
Predictions for this match, Vincent?
I don't know, maybe Master's going to combo game again.
Yeah,
or
that's my guess as well.
Going to keep the accuracy going. But to be honest though, this map has a lot of burst and streaming parts, so I think Ari has a big advantage looking by his pick number 2.
Both players actually have similar accuracy right now, for now.
Yep, but
I mean,
well, this
combo.
Yes, but this is the tiebreaker, so a bit at the early is not
dropped a lot of accuracy.
Yep, by the first. I think he is over, yep, he is overstreaming, I think. Oh, okay then,
Yes,
the thing is, this map has a lot of stream paths, so I think that will be Master's disadvantage though, unless he can keep the combo right.
Unless if he gets used to the BBM.
Yes.
If
he has to do it, and Ari need to break at one point.
Oh, a bit of that.
Yeah,
he almost break there, ladies and gentlemen.
All is well though, because he still has his combo.
Yep, he's still winning by the combo, but accuracy wise is really bad. The differences though.
And the score will just keep going for Arimaki's way. If he keeps his accuracy on the 80s. Oh, and yeah, he dropped a lot of 100s there. Yeah. Okay, that was fine. That was fine. He only dropped one 100 there. And
almost. Yep,
yeah, he seems like he's improving slightly.
He is adapting
the
game now.
And his timing is getting better.
Alright, halfway through, Ari is still winning with the accuracy, while Master is facing up with the combo gaming. And then I need to bonk Benjo again. Hold on, be right back. Let me bonk Benjo. Come on, Benjo. Work. Benjo, hello. Okay, Benjo, do Benjo things. Okay, wait.
We're back.
A bit dizzying though, I think. There is a bit of dizzying, but...
It will load again.
Okay then, restart a bit. Okay. Yep, we're back. Hold on. Okay.
Missed a little bit of the map. But both combo, both players are holding their combo.
They're still holding their combo. While Master in the other... Okay, Master just break at the bus ladder drop at the end. Okay.
This is very bad for Master right now.
Yep, this is very bad for Maslow right now.
Arimaki has to break like really soon for Maslow to have a chance to win this.
Well, but I don't think there will be any sort of chance, because if I remember, the next part is all bursty and streaming, so
Arimaki is way too good at that.
This is Arimaki's advantage. Okay then, just like my prediction. Yep, so yeah, Arismaki going to win because of his advantage at Norma 2 handling the burst and also the stream part. Well, Master at the disadvantage because this map requires a lot of low aim on the stream and low PPM stream, because yes, we all know what PPM is this. So yeah, well,
Arismaki gets 1000 combo.
Yep, I think this is gonna wrap it, guys.
Yep.
Okay, I think this is going to settle it. Master lose to Arimaki at the tiebreaker. Arimaki is holding combo with 1001. Okay, Master just saying OVO. What was it? OVO.
Wow.
Wow.
No, not wow. Wawaro. Wawaro XD.
Wawaro. Okay, then never mind. Alright then, well, that's a wrap. Well, I'm sorry to say, Master got eliminated, lost to Arimaki 4-3, while Arimaki is going to advance to round of 64.
Good effort by Master though,
making it to tiebreaker. You know, the trouble for Master is literally the stream handling.
Yeah.
Just that it.
Maybe on if it was a higher SR, he might have been fine.
Yes, Master is a high star rating pass player. So yeah, I think that settles it. Congratulations to Arimaki. Good game, well played. You guys made it to the tiebreaker. Okay then, I think that is going to wrap things up. The next stream will be in 20 minutes, I think. Let me check again. One second.
EKNS N0.
Yep, the next stream is in 19 minutes between BKNS and 01519.
Similar seat placement with this map
also. Alright, well, thank you guys so much for watching the stream.
Thank you, Vincent, for casting with me.
Yep, thank you also for coming in, because I feel lonely, so...
unfortunately, I won't be joining you for the next one.
Yeah, I know, you have a mess to do, so yeah. Okay, right. Goodbye everyone, see you on the next stream, bye-bye!
See you in 20 minutes!